research, I knew that immigrants and people who were connected spiritually had very hybridic and fluid connections to each other and to themselves, and that their identities were incredibly fluid and complex. But I really underestimated to what degree that fluidity existed. Interviewing Jose Luis Gutierrez and his daughter Marcela really opened my eyes to a whole new idea of how fluid identity could become. And you see this as Marcela puts it, it's a triangle of your soul and your mind and your body. And that's where art plays in. Art is the triangle of the soul, the mind, and the body. Art is everything. They really see art as a higher being, higher power. And it's a spiritual connectivity, both with yourself to other people, yourself to yourself, different parts of yourself, and different parts of yourself in art, and in expression, and in interaction, and everything. And that really revolutionized the idea of, so what is the soul? What is the soul's part in this? What is the soul saying in this piece of art? And that's what the base of this whole study is what is the soul's expression in art?
Yo inicié mi cuestión artística en una forma autodidacta. Es un don. Porque sin haber asistido a escuela alguna, ni haber tomado clases, yo hacía mis propios dibujos artísticos. Y me apreciaban. Yo no sabía ni por qué, pero en sí, es que siendo autodidacta, yo era capaz de reproducir obras como la Gioconda, el David y algunas de las obras clásicas, solamente porque yo las tenía en la mente. Uh-huh. Las vi en un libro. Y, posiblemente, al paso del tiempo, y por mi estupidez, jamás inicié una carrera profesional. Simplemente por amor al arte.
But so I've definitely grown up in a household where art was very encouraged. My father's an artist. My mother's an artist as well. She was a singer and a pianist, so she did the Conservatory of Paris, so definitely pushed us to go towards that. I started performing, I think, when I was about 3, so a lot of singing, a lot of dancing, a lot of theater too. I did that, and I always appreciated it. I was a very shy child, so it was my first social skill was dancing, but helped a lot. And it just allowed me to express who I am outside of the norms that people see you in. I was in a Jewish private school looking this Mexican. So it really allowed me to show a different side of my person.
Obviamente que en una forma positiva, quien aprecia el arte tiene una sensibilidad obviamente artística, pero más que ello, más humanitaria. Porque hay infinidad de artistas que sienten una sensibilidad, pero lo supera su ego, egocentrismo.
I was exposed to a lot of physical pain as a younger. My mother was very ill. So I think seeing an artist that was able to express her own pain in both psychological and physiological ways means through an artistic medium felt so powerful to me, because it was kind of combining what I was observing and what I was also feeling inside. So that automatically goes to my mom, you know? That's the connection that my brain did when I discovered Fira. I remember discovering and be like, oh shit, she knows. She really knows. And just, yeah, it's so cathartic. It's just so cathartic for me to just be able to express some of the deep feelings that we don't really allow you to show pain in society. So I think that having mediums, whether they're paintings or songs or dance, to express that, and for it to be almost like to be applauded and kind of, yeah, celebrated, is pretty powerful.
Pero ese es un sentir que no se vende en las farmacias ni en ningún supermercado. Es una cuestión con la que, pues, naces.
I'm a particular case being mixed. You have to deal with hybridity on a daily level, like on a daily basis. And I don't say Montreal helped me, like, find my Mexican side, and because Mexicans are at one margin, and I guess I was at another one, you know, so we weren't like really cohabitating. It's really my personal willingness and desire to learn about my culture, and like, I guess religion helped a lot. That was the side that I was raised in, like Catholicism, but other than that, it was my willingness to go and travel and actually discover Mexico and discover my culture and discover other cultures that.
Es un atractivo a nivel mundial, Montreal, para la cuestión artística. No se encuentran ciudades como esta en muchas partes del mundo. Pekín es grande, Tokio es enorme, México es cuarta ciudad en el mundo, pero no existe la tranquilidad ni la apreciación como existe aquí en Montreal. La cuestión del origen disminuye ante la actualidad, en la cual hay muchas más oportunidades, más claras, que en mi país de origen. ¿Comprendes? Si hay alguien que desea realizar un evento artístico, aquí lo aprecian e incluso te tienden la mano. En mi país no. No es que seamos malos, es que somos más toda la población que hay en Canadá, todo existe nomás en una ciudad de México.
I was raised in Catholicism and Judaism, so Jewish and Catholic, and I think I for a long time, I was more on the agnostic side. I don't know if I use that term anymore, because I'm so, more and more I find like that the Buddhist philosophy is applicable to my conception of what spirituality is. And then just shaping my own spiritual, you know, like, compass, I don't know, like my own way of seeing the world is very spiritual, and I don't think I need a religion to guide it, because I think it's more of a set of rules to help you, not necessarily, it shouldn't restrain you from doing
it. Mi estado anímico o religioso. Hay quienes tienen una inclinación muy tendida sobre la religión. Son personas muy sensitivas, pero que no se enmarcan en un estilo de religiosidad.
Yeah, I believe in something greater, but will I call it God? I'm not sure. I'd call it art. Call it love. I'd call it, yeah, but beauty or all its forms, but I don't know if there's one God and he has a white beard, you know? Art is soul talk. It really is. It's getting that feeling that isn't necessarily part of your mind or your body, something that feels innate to everyone and any being, you know, and it's talking to that component. And it's making people feel on that level, and you can feel whatever you want with whatever I give you, whatever I was able to produce, and you will have probably a very different experience than my sister or anyone else who lives that experience. But my goal as an artist is to speak to that part of you and to speak to that part of myself.
Escribir cualquier tipo de pintura cuando está bien, esta persona es pinta sobre las flores, sobre lagos, sobre cuestiones campestres, que es una persona sensitiva.
Sí.
Y hay quienes pintan solamente cuadros en los que brilla la violencia. ¿Verdad? Y psicológicamente dices, esta persona no está muy contenta con nuestra cultura ni con nuestra sociedad. Repito, que la descripción que un artista hace sobre su estado de ánimo lo plasma en la pintura. Las personas que tienen un determinado resentimiento contra los medios que lo entornan, que lo rodean, refleja esos sentimientos a veces sobre el lienzo, sobre la pintura. Es una faceta que no puedes ocultar. Digo que una persona con tendencias religiosas te anda pintando angelitos y santitos, porque es hasta donde lo permite su misma capacidad, el mismo sentir. Pero si a una persona con tendencias bélicas le pides que te dibuje un santo, sí te va a dibujar un santo, pero con una espada al hombro o puñales alrededor de su cintura. ¿Por qué? Porque es una persona con esa tendencia violenta. ¿Sí? Hay otras personas feminoides, hombres, porque les gusta bailar ballet o cualquier cosa. Y tú sabes que cuando piensas sobre ello, te estás saliendo del margen en el cual la sociedad te acepta. A ti te gusta el ballet y eso, lo menos que te puede decir la mayoría, ese cabrón es marica. Sí, siendo que no, es un arte, una expresión. Al pintor le dice, no, ese huevo no hace nada positivo. Debiera de ponerse a pegar ladrillos, hacer bardas, construir. Porque todo mundo estamos aptos para criticar, pero jamás para aportar algo positivo. La mayoría somos, ¿verdad? Así es que cuando hay una persona que tiene algunos principios geniales, por decirlo de alguna manera, pues debe ser apreciada. ¿Sí? Yo tengo amigos que son maricas, más feos que una pedrada en los dientes, y otros que son afeminados, pero son muy hombres. Pero, pues así lo dotó la naturaleza. Es que contra los principios de la natura, nada, mi hermano. Y debemos de aceptar a quienes están en nuestro alrededor, tal y cual son. Así como ellos te aceptan a ti tal como eres. Eso es convivencia. Eso es aceptar el factor humanitario.